So dear students, welcome to Mac Forum. Today we are going to discuss about the meaning of a term called as a delta dot V. Now what is delta dot V? Actually the delta dot V is termed as a divergence. Fine, it is called as a divergence. Now we are considering the case in which the fluid particle is moving. And by considering that case, we have to derive the or we have to state what is the value of delta dot V, what exactly the divergence is. Now, as you know that if the control volume is moving in a flow field, its mass will remain constant, because that same amount of mass is traveling through a particular fixed control volume which is moving around a flow field. Now, but as that control volume is moving around a flow field, mass will not increase or decrease, but there is a change in the volume. Volume may increase or decrease, and there is a change in the, its surface area also. Its elemental surface will also change. Why? Because the fluid is moving to a different region in a flow, and at different region, there might be the change in the property called as a density. हर अलग जगह पे डेंसिटी की वैल्यू अलग होगी, बट मास फिक्स रहेगा. मास इंक्रीज भी नहीं होगा, डिक्रीज भी नहीं होगा, बट उसका कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम चेंज हो सकता है, वॉल्यूम चेंज हो सकता है, कंट्रोल सरफेस भी चेंज हो सकता है. फाइन, नाउ वी आर मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द डिराइविंग द वैल्यू ऑफ डेल डॉट वी. नाउ लेट अस टेक एन एग्जांपल. दिस इज ए कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम एंड दिस इज द एलिमेंटल सरफेस डीएस. And moving with a velocity vector v, and n is the normal to the elemental surface. Now after a time interval of a delta t, there is a change in the volume. How much is the change in the volume after time delta t? Is nothing but v into delta v t. This is the amount of change in the volume when the elemental surface is moving with a velocity vector v. So this is the change in volume. So we can write it as n vector ds is nothing but it is equals to ds only. So we have replaced, and this is the change in the volume for a particular infinitely small surface if it is moving with the velocity v, and after time delta t, this is the change in the volume. Now if you want to find out change in the total change in the volume of a whole control volume, which is equals to what? Submission over the control surface. अभी हमने सिर्फ small control surface लिया है. Now we will submit it over whole control surface and will put the limit ds tends to 0. Then this term will become the surface integral. Means ये क्या था, आपका एक volume था, change हो रहा था, कितना after time t के बाद. But आपको निकालना है total control volume में कितना change हो रहा है, तो हमें इसको क्या करना पड़ेगा, summation करना पड़ेगा पूरे control surface पे. और limit अगर हम उसको ds tends to 0 देंगे, then this term will become the surface integral. Fine. Now if we divide this term by delta t, suppose we have given delta t se divide kar diya, so delta t will get cancel out in the further, and this term is nothing but dv by dt. It is the what, time rate of change. Yahan mein kya nikalna hai, time rate of change of a volume. Clear? It is a time rate of change. Now dv by dt is nothing but what, if you cancel delta t and delta t here, you will get v ds. Now this is the surface integral and this is the volume integral. So for conversion from surface integral to volume integral, we are applying a what method called as a Gauss divergence theorem. Yes, in the previous lecture we have seen what is the Gauss divergence theorem. It converts the surface integral to the what, volume integral. So this surface integral got converted into volume integral by the use of a term called as a delta. Now this is the end result. Now this is for the whole volume. If you want to find it for a very 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 small volume, what is the change? Now we will see what is the change. So let volume is nothing but we are replacing volume by
very small volume delta V. So it will become d upon dt. This is the substantial derivative or the material derivative. Why? Because the fluid particle is moving fine and it is going with the Lagrangian approach. So we are getting the what? Which derivative? Substantial or the material derivative. So yahan pe aa jayega aapka delta V. Here it also become delta V, del dot V, delta V. Now, this is for a very small volume. Agar aapka volume bahut hi zyada small hai, to iska integral yahan se nikal jayega. Means what we are getting, d delta V upon dt is nothing but del dot V vector delta V. Fine? ये हमको मिल जाएगा. क्यों? क्योंकि वॉल्यूम बहुत स्मॉल है. इसका इंटीग्रल करोगे तो भी आपको यही वैल्यू मिलने वाली है. फाइन. आफ्टर दैट इफ वी रीअरेंज द टर्म वी विल गेट डेल डॉट वी इज नथिंग बट व्हाट वन अपॉन डेल्टा वी इनटू डी अपॉन डीटी डेल्टा वी. फाइन. सो हमें क्या निकालना था? मीनिंग ऑफ डेल डॉट वी. वी गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ डेल डॉट वी. नाउ व्हाट डज इट रिप्रेजेंट? इट इज अ डाइवर्जेंस. एंड व्हाट इज एक्चुअली द डाइवर्जेंस? टाइम रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ वॉल्यूम ऑफ द फ्लूइड एलिमेंट पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम यहाँ लिखा गया है. डी बाई डी टी क्या था? टाइम रेट ऑफ चेंज. सो टाइम रेट ऑफ चेंज किसका चेंज? ऑफ ए मूविंग फ्लूइड एलिमेंट. क्योंकि आपका कौन सा अप्रोच है इसमें? लैग्रेंजियन अप्रोच है. हमने पहले अज्यूम किया कि हमारा फ्लूइड एलिमेंट मूव हो रहा है, मास कांस्टेंट है उसके अंदर. सो एंड इट इज पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम. सो डाइवर्जेंस का एक्चुअल मीनिंग क्या होता है? टाइम रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ वॉल्यूम ऑफ ए मूविंग फ्लूइड एलिमेंट पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम. हो द डेरिवेशन ऑफ डेल डॉट वी इज क्लियर टू यू. फाइन. टिल देन थैंक यू.